times, if any, that you will use a V-plow. But when it's needed, there is no other plow that can replace the V-plow. The V-plow is generally called in when the drifts are just too big for straight blade plows to handle. And in most cases, that means that snow is totally blocking traffic. When you come upon a drift, set the V-plow down on its shoes and then evaluate what will be the best way to open the road. The best plan is to try to split the drift so that you end up moving most of the snow to the side of the road where the drift is the shallowest. For example, let's say you are traveling west and come upon a large drift that has formed on the south shoulder and extends across the road to the other side. With this drift, you would probably want to make your first pass with a V-plow at the south edge of the road, planning to move most of the snow to the north side of the road away from the deep part of the drift. Make your first pass through the drift with your wing up. It isn't a good idea to use the wing during the initial breakthrough. If the drift is not too deep, the wing and V-plow can be used to move the remaining snow from the roadway. Many times, as with the example you just saw, you will be able to plow all the way through a drift without backing up. But large drifts are an exception. Instead of attempting to make it all the way through in one pass, make a series of thrusts into the drift, attacking one side and then the other. When going into a heavy drift, high speed is not recommended. Move into the drift slowly. If you hit the drift with too much speed, snow may roll up and over the V-plow and fall between the plow and the truck. When this happens, your chances of getting stuck are very great. Another problem with excess speed is that there is the potential of damaging the push arms on the V-plow. Also, make sure that you have a wide enough path behind you so that you can back out of the drift. If you get in too far, you might find yourself in the middle of a drift and unable to move in any direction. One word of caution: always look behind you before backing up. Motorists have been known to follow plows right into drifts. There may be times when drifts are so large, a snowblower will be required to clear the road. If so, there are snowblowers and trained operators at selected shops around the state that will be called in by your supervisor.